clean lines and precision, all cheekbones and cut glass, collarbones that shred my fingers every time I try and caress them. Me, burned and bruised, stretch marks like river streams swimming from the thick of my thighs through the expanse of my belly, smears of discontent in the places that life went finger painting like a hyperactive 5-year-old. What a match made in heaven, then God has a pretty fucked up sense of humor. Sky when I remembered how much they reminded me of cancerous spots on inky black, a pulsating nebula of noxious gases all consumed by their own flames, decaying, dying, screaming in the dead silence of space, waiting for the moment they collapse in on themselves. There are times when I feel like I'm waiting to collapse in on myself. I am screaming the silence of my own head. Bone prison shaped like a skull, hosting thoughts that push against the inside of the walls, wailing to be let out. Their clawing fingers never leave a trace on the outside. This prison is corrupting from the outside. I have a delicate relationship with fairy lights, twinkling orbs that remind me of stars in the night sky, slowly pulsing with colors, all vibrant colors that melt into each other with each gulp of alcohol I take to help myself forget how much I fear the stars, how much I fear the lonely when the sun disappears. Fairy lights remind me that electric current running through tiny bulbs can shock you and make you cry as your mother chastises you for fiddling with Diwali decorations. Whoever said that love is patient was a liar. Love is not patient, love is not kind, love is a viral incubus that will fester in your bones. Around yourself, love is a noxious gas that stars are made of. Love is a supernova that ends the world with a whimper, because in space no sound ever escapes the lips of an explosion. Stars look so pretty from a distance, we forget that they are representations of dead titans in an all-consuming void that remains unforgiving. A void that houses spinning balls of fire that accumulate enough energy to destroy themselves. A void that is content with sudden explosions is constantly on the run from itself. A void is constantly expanding with not enough fires to keep itself warm. Streams of light hang from rooftops and terraces and balconies, all of them shining bright and pretty, all of them shining festive, frail, flammable. All the lights in the world may be able to guide you home, but your bones will be ignited one day. They like mixed circuitry, electric and pure bones, same difference, but all collapsing in on ourselves. The sun starts to set and the sky blushes, rosy red at first, and then a slow, gradual descent into snarling purple. Bruises of yellow and blue intersperse the moment the last starts to die. The flicker of fairy lights makes my face look radiant in the dim of the evening. I have that light that shines from within. I have that glow. I have that blinding, bright luminescence. I have that burning in the center of my face that makes me shine. As murky night takes over the sky, I blush when the stars come out, rosy red at first, and then a gradual descent as my lips snarl purple, then blue. I may be choking, but I am not cold in the dead of night. I am burning every second I live, and so I keep myself warm. Someone once told me that I look like a boy who was running away from home. I don't know what or where home is anymore. I don't think I'll ever know. I'm constantly running away from my own center. I am content with silent explosions in my skull, because as long as I can keep the toxic flames in me burning, I can stay warm. The world outside will view me from a distance and tell me I have stars in my eyes.